supporting everyone else, you know. And I've watched my dad. And the funny part is, man, people always say, I don't want to work at McDonald's the rest of my life. You know, like, and I look at my dad, bro, because he's somebody that's worked at McDonald's his entire life, but he makes, you know, six figures kind of chilling, you know?
Yeah.
Like, he works 20, 25 hours a week working at McDonald's, and he makes, you know, six figures. Like, he's like an area supervisor.
I was about to ask, how does he pull that one off?
Yeah. Well,
so how many years total?
He's been there a while, man. He's been there, but he became a supervisor probably like 15 years ago, man.
I would be, do you know what would be cool? That's awesome to hear. Find out what his starting pay was. Do you know? Mm-hmm. Minimum wage, probably. And it must have been way less.
Oh, yeah. It was back in the day. He was a cook back in the day in Silver City.
So he must have been making like $5 an hour, maybe.
If that, bro.
If that.
If that.
Yeah.
Like, dude, back in, that's like 1980 type stuff.
Bro, that is a story right there.
Yeah, dude.
Like, from that to where the person's at. And that should be like the whole title of whatever it is, a book or
yeah, dude.
Tell them, come on here, I'll interview them.
And it's crazy, bro. It's crazy. Like I said, you know, you hear people, like, it's always like, oh, you don't want to work at McDonald's the whole life. And I just remember a substitute told me that in seventh grade. She's all, you're gonna grow up working at McDonald's, because I don't know what I'd done to make her mad. I think because like I said, I wasn't really like a troublemaker. Yeah. You know, I don't know what I'd done to make her mad, but she was like, you're going to grow up to work at McDonald's one day. And I said, that's fine. My dad makes three times more money than you do anyways working at McDonald's.
I think that's our teachers in our generation. We're kind of like
kind of cold. Yeah, especially like
that anymore.
Yeah, especially substitutes.
So that's not weird to hear. So that whenever you're like, I don't know what I did wrong.
Yeah.
I had teachers tell me horrible stuff. I've heard stories of people, and so I totally believe it.
Yeah.
Teachers just said, and then the whole, you don't want to work at McDonald's your whole life. They need to change that, because it's like, we live in this world, and I'm in college now, but I'm 31 years old.
Yeah.
And it's like, and I didn't even go to college till like 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And there's always this huge thing where it's like, if you don't go to college, you can't be successful kind of thing. And it's like, look, college is good. I'm not telling anyone not to go to college, but it's cool to hear stories like yours, because there's other things you can do.
Yeah.
There's trade work too. There's business school. If you wanted to do like a year and a half, two years, even
an
associates or something, there's options. But it's like the whole, like, you don't work at McDonald's your whole life. They got to change that, because, which is why that story is cool, because why not? What you don't want to do is be in the same job
your whole life,
or the same position. But if you're moving up and you're progressing, then that isn't that the American dream, to move forward in life?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's what I always tell people too. You know, like, you said it perfect. You know, everyone's like, oh, well, you don't want to work at McDonald's your whole life. No, it's like, no, you don't want to be a cook your whole life.
Yes.
You know, you don't want to be a cashier your whole life. You don't want to wash dishes your whole life. You want to progress. Like, if you're not progressing, then what are you doing?
Yeah, you're settling for whatever job it is. And it's the same thing for people that aren't cooks. You know, people get really good paying jobs and never apply for promotions.
Exactly.
For like 20, 30 years, they're just on the same level job.
Yeah.
And that's not good either. Like, you know what I mean? And your dad's proved that. And I work.
Hey, fun random fact of the day. The Cookie Monster from Sesame Street has a real name, and his name is Sid. Not a lot of people know that. They just started calling him the Cookie Monster because that's what he is. Google it. And if it's true, which it is, come back here and subscribe.